Hello everyone, and welcome to the final chapter in my 12-part series on video production for small business owners and nonprofits. Over the last 3 months, I have taught you how to use your iPhone to shoot a commercial to support your business. In this chapter, I'm going to teach you how to upload that commercial to YouTube, link it up with Google Ads, and target it at local viewers based on zip codes. I decided to make this course because we live in a world where the only people who can afford to advertise on television are lawyers, car dealerships, and big pharma. Television advertising is expensive to produce, even more costly to keep on the air, making it a high-risk option for most small businesses. The method that I'm about to teach you puts you in the driver's seat. You control exactly how much you spend, whether that's $25 a day or $2,500 a day. If you want to only target the three surrounding zip codes around your business, that's an option. If later on down the road you want to expand beyond that, you can. And if times ever get tough, you can pause the campaign with one click. As we have gone through this course, I have used this as an opportunity to profile how a small business can use this type of marketing plan. The name of the business that we've been working with is Chequessett Chocolate in North Truro, Massachusetts. And the last thing that I want to do before I teach you how to upload your commercial and set up the campaign, let's take one last look at the final cut of the commercial that we created together. And keep in mind, this is all shot on the iPhone, minus two drone shots at the beginning. Take a look.
Chequessett Chocolate, a bean to bar chocolate company located on Cape Cod at 8 Highland Road in North Truro, Massachusetts. We handcraft our chocolate in small batches from fine flavor direct trade cacao. We serve a full menu of delicious coffee and chocolate drinks and an ever-changing selection of chocolate confections. You can even watch the process while you sip and shop. We also feature a craft chocolate library from other craft makers from around the world. Come check us out in store or online at chequessettchocolate.com and learn where your chocolate comes from. It's not just a chocolate bar, it's an experience.
Thinkific students, I'm going to give you access to the XML file of that edit so that way you can see exactly how it looks in Final Cut Pro. You will find the link to that file as well as instructions on how to use it down below in the notes section. At the end of the last chapter, we exported our final cut to the desktop along with the SRT file containing the closed caption data. Let's start by uploading our video to YouTube. From the YouTube homepage, we will click on this icon at the top right and select Upload Video. I'll now point it to the MP4 file that is currently on my desktop. We are now going to start entering the information about this video, including the title, description, and tags. What I want you to know about this process is you do not need to obsess over this part. The video that we are creating is just going to be used as an ad, so we don't really need to worry about perfecting things like tags. The main thing that we need at this stage of the game is the URL of the video, which you will find right here. When writing the description, I want you to focus your energy on the first two lines. Try to find a way to creatively get your keywords in there as well as the URL to your website. You'll also want to include the important contact information, including your business's address, phone number, and social media links. You can add up to three hashtags in the description of the video, although it is questionable at this point if that actually helps you anymore. I'll now navigate to an image that I'm going to use as the thumbnail for the video. We can skip over a bunch of these other things, but let's just make sure that we mark it as not for kids. When it comes to adding tags to your video, just try to think about what people are searching for when they're on Google. So for example, I might put best coffee on Cape Cod, as well as the name of the town, the name of the business, etc. You can always beef this part up later, so again, don't obsess, just put something in here so that it's got something, and let's move on. Let's now click over to Video Elements and add in our subtitles. So now I'll click on Upload File and tell it that our file does include timing. Now I'll navigate to the file, which is on the desktop. Looks good to me. And now I'll click Done. Now I'm going to click over to the Visibility tab, change the privacy options to Public. Now I'm going to click and highlight the URL of the video and copy it to the clipboard, since we're going to need that URL in just a moment. And finally, let's click Publish. At this point, we are done with YouTube, and the rest of this process takes place on Google Ads. So at this point, I'm going to log in to ads.google.com. From here, let's create a new campaign. Now let's click Create a New Campaign without a goals guidance. In this next section, let's select Video, and in this last section, select Custom Video Campaign. And now click Continue. On this next screen, I'm going to give my campaign a name, and you might want to consider adding the date in the name. Here where it says bid strategy, I recommend that you go with CPV, which stands for cost per view. Let's change this away from campaign total, and instead let's go with a daily budget. My recommendation is to do no less than $25 a day, but like I said, you're the boss. In this next section where it says networks, I want you to uncheck everything except YouTube videos. Here under locations, we are going to click on enter another location and then click advanced search. At the top of the next screen, we have the option to set a specific location or use a radius. Because of the shape of Cape Cod, I'm going to go with location and I'm just going to add them in bulk, listing one zip code per line. When you're done, click search, and now I'm going to select target all and click save. One of the things that's also important when you're creating a YouTube campaign is to exclude your video from being shown to certain audiences. So for example, I recommend here under exclude types and labels that you check the boxes next to embedded, live streaming, and games. As far as ratings, this is going to depend on your type of business. In the case of Chequessett Chocolate, I think it's probably best that we not associate with mature content. In this section, we can create a name for our group. For this example, I'm just going to call this First Local Target, and we're going to keep things super generic. Scrolling down a bit further, we get to demographics, which is where we have the ability to market to a specific gender, age group, parental status, or approximate household income. Let's now scroll down to bidding and have a little discussion about this section. This is where you can enter how much you're willing to pay per video view. I want you to have the expectation that when you do this for the first time, you probably won't see a lot of action. I advise you to slowly increase the bid every day by a couple of cents until you see the results start to pick up. You don't want to pay more than you need to, so start low and then work your way up. Another option is you can make a bid adjustment, but my advice is to keep this percentage on the low side. Finally, in this section, we are going to paste the video URL. I'm going to select the option to turn this into a skippable in-stream ad. Add the website link, and we are good to go. It takes Google around 24 to 48 hours to approve the ad, and that's it. Folks, it has been a pleasure to offer this course. I realize a lot of people out there have questions as they are going through the learning process. If you would ever like to work with me privately, please know that remote private lessons is one of the things that I do. You can book a 1-hour session with me through my website at techtalkamerica.com/private lessons. I'd like to thank my sponsor, motionvfx.com, maker of the world's best effects and templates for Final Cut Pro. I'd also like to thank a very good friend of mine by the name of Jeff Greenberg, who is one of the most talented editors slash teachers I've ever met. Jeff has always been there for me anytime I had questions as I was going through and creating this course. Thank you, Jeff, for all of your wisdom. Finally, I'd like to thank all of you out there who participated and took this class from home. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox. Class dismissed.